Yes, you see this problem. Problem number 17. In this problem, the probability that a bomb hits the target is 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means for every 4 bombs, one bomb will hit the target. One bomb, if you hit 4 bombs, one bomb will hit the target. Okay, if you drop, suppose you drop 4 bombs, out of 4 bombs, one bomb will hit the target, means your aim. Okay, then 4 bombs are aimed at a bridge. 4 bombs aimed at a bridge means your aim is to destroy the bridge, means your aim is to drop a bomb on bridge. Okay, then probability is 1 by 4. You dropped four bombs. Four bombs are aimed at a bridge, means 4 bombs you dropped. Then they say that 2 bombs hit are enough to destroy the bridge. 2 bombs hit are enough to destroy the bridge. Means what it means? If you want to destroy the bridge, you have to drop 2 bombs. 2 bombs you have to drop on the bridge. If 2 bombs hit the bridge, the bridge will destroy. Okay, remember this. Then what is the probability that the bridge is destroyed? What is the probability that the bridge is destroyed? This is the first question. Then second question is, what is the probability that all 4 bombs hit the bridge? There are 2 questions. First question is, what is the probability that the bridge is destroyed? Means, suppose you consider the bridge is destroyed, then how many bombs dropped exactly on the bridge? Anyone tell me. The bridge is already destroyed. Okay, 4 bombs dropped. Okay, 4 bomb drops dropped, or 4 bombs targeted on the bridge, and you have dropped the bombs, then the bridge destroyed. After dropping the 4 bombs, the bridge is destroyed. You tell me how many bombs were dropped on the bridge? How many bombs hit that bridge? Yes, anybody on your audio and tell me. Are you understanding or not? Yes. Two bombs are enough to destroy the bridge. Okay, if 2 bombs you hit on the bridge will destroy. But 4 bombs you dropped on the bridge. Out of 4 bombs, how many bombs hit the bridge? Already bridge is destroyed. Are you understanding or not? So, n probability of, in this problem, there are 4 bombs. there are four bombs, so n is 4. Probability of hitting the bridge is 1/4. Okay, so Q is equal to 1 minus P. So Q is equal to 1 minus 4 is equal to 3/4. 3/4. Then binomial equation is probability of x is equal to ncx p raised to x q raised to n minus x. Okay, so you tell me what is the probability in the first question. How many bombs drop on the bridge?
Four
bombs. All four bombs. How many bombs are necessary to hit the destroy the bridge?
Two.
Okay. The bridge is already destroyed. You don't know how many bombs hit that bridge exactly, but bridge is already destroyed. If that bridge is destroyed, at least minimum two bombs should be targeted on the bridge. Okay, two bombs. If you drop two bombs, the bridge will destroy. Okay. If you drop three bombs, the bridge will destroy. If you drop four bombs, the bridge will destroy. You remember, out of four bombs, if none bomb hit that bridge, the bridge will not destroy. None means zero. If one bomb, out of four bombs, one bomb hit the bridge, the bomb bridge will not destroy. If two bombs hit the bridge will destroy. Three bombs hit the bridge will destroy. Four bombs hit the bridge will destroy. So, the bomb, the bridge is destroyed means out of four bombs, two bombs may hit the bridge, or three bombs may be hit the bridge, or all the four bombs may be hit the bridge. Remember this. So, the x is greater than 1. The value of your x, how many bombs hit the bridge means more than one bomb hit the bridge. Am I right? The fourth bomb only bomb vakidari bridge mega bridge destroy agaitan tandra yet bomb biddav kelagatharu. Bridge destroy agait, bridge halagagait, yet bomb biddav anta kedra. Otta bomb bidadarka bridge destroy aagtatena? Illa. One bomb bidra destroy agudala. ಎರಡ್ ಬಾಂಬ್ ಹತ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಬಿದ್ದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಏನಾಗ್ತೈತಿ? ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ. ನೀವು ನಾಲ್ಕು ಬಾಂಬ್ ಹಾಕಿದಿರಿ, ನಾಲ್ಕದ್ರಾಗ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಾಂಬ್ ಬಿದ್ದಾವ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಿದ್ದಾವ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ, ಒಂದು ಬಿದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ, ಎರಡು ಬಿದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗ್ತೈತಿ. ಎರಡರೇ ಬೀಳಾಕ್ಬೇಕು ಒಂದು, ಇಲ್ಲ ಎರಡು ಇಲ್ಲಾಂದ್ರೆ ಮೂರು ಬಿದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತೈತಿ. ಅದು ನಾಲ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ನಾಲ್ಕು ಬಿದ್ದರೂ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತೈತಿ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಿಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ, ದಿ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಾಯ್ಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ the x value is more than one bomb hit the bridge. The answer is more than one bomb means 2, 3, 4. Remember this, 2, 3, 4. So instead of calculating 2 bomb, 3 bomb, 4 bomb, you calculate complementary of that. The total probability is 1. Out of that, you deduct number of bombs not hit the bridge. The number of bombs not hit the bridge means the zero, the probability of zero. No bomb hit the bridge. And another is one bomb hit the bridge. So, x value is greater than 1 means more than one bomb hit the bridge. So the bridge destroyed. So you have to calculate 3. X is equal to 2, X is equal to 3, X is equal to 4. you will get the answer. But instead of calculating three, you calculate only two by making complementary. By making complementary, that is greater than x is complementary of less than two. Less than two. You better have done bridge. What are the length angle? Three. Here we get the kami bomb withdraw. Suppose less than two bombs hit the bridge. Less than two bombs hit the bridge. The bomb will not destroy. Sorry, bridge will not destroy. The bridge will not destroy. Therefore, less than two means 1, 0. 1 and 0. Therefore, I'll take probability of x is equal to 1 minus probability of x is equal to 0. And another term is plus probability of x is equal to 1. You see here. If you draw 4 bombs, out of 4 bombs, none hit the bridge. None hit the bridge means no one bombs hit the bridge, means x value is 0. If one bomb hit the bridge, out of 4 bombs, one bomb hit the bridge will not destroy. So, no bombs hit the bridge will not destroy. One bomb hit the bridge, out of 4, the bridge will not destroy. Therefore, out of total 1 probability, you deduct 0 and 1 value. Okay, 0 and 1 value. So, in this equation, you put n value and x value as per this. First equation, second equation. You write this equation 2 times and ascertain the answer. You see here. Probability of x is greater than, probability x is greater than x is equal to 1 minus probability of ncx. This is the first bracket. Plus second bracket value. Like this you write. So probability of x is probability of x is greater than 1 is equal to 1 minus, total probability is 1. We're making complementary. Minus, first bracket is not required. x0, p is 0.25. 0.25 means 1 by 4. 1 by 4 means 0.25, remember this. 1 divided by 4 means 0.25. 0.25 raised to x. X is 0. And q is 3 by 4. 3 by 4 means 0.75. 0.75 raised to n is 4. X is 0. You fill the value of x and n in this bracket. First bracket completed. Come to the second one. Second bracket. In the second bracket, you fill x value 1. X value 1. So 4c1 is equal to 0.25 raised to 1. X value is 1. 0.75 raised to 4 minus 1. 4 minus 1. N minus x. Lx ethi, ali x value tumri. Ln value ethi, ali n value tumri. E erad bracket irukonda. Okay. You fill the value. You fill the value. Okay. And simplify it. N 4C0. 4C0 means 1. Remember this. 4 combination 0 is 1. 1 minus 1 into 0.25. 0.25 raised to 0 into 0.75 raised to 4. 4 minus 0 is equal to 4. Then next is 4C1. 4C1 value is 4, 0.25 raised to 1, 0.75 raised to 3, 4 minus 1. Okay. Then next step, 1 minus 0.25 raised to 0 means 1. 0.25 raised to 0 means 1. You multiply 0.75 4 times. 0.75 into 4 is equal to 0.31641. One is one. 0.25 raised to 0 means 1. 1 into 1 is 1. And only value of this 0.75 raised to 4. 0.75 raised to 4 is equal to, this is the answer. This is the answer. Okay. Next bracket you solve. You simplify the next part. In the next part, 4 is 4. 0.25 raised to 1 means 0.25. 0.75 raised to 3. 0.75 raised to 3 is equal to 0.75. Multiply, its answer is 0.421875. Okay. Then you take the next step. 1 minus 0.031641 plus, if you multiply this, 4 into 0.25, 4 into 0.25 is equal to 1. 1 into this is equal to same answer comes. 0.25 into 0.25 is 1. 1 into 0.421875 is the same value comes. And then you take the total of the first two. So probability of X is greater than 1 is equal to 1 minus 0.7383, and its answer is 0.2617. That means probability of destroying the bridge is 0.2617. This is the answer. You block it and mark it. Okay, this is the answer. End it out. And second question is there. What is the probability that all 4 bombs hit the bridge? Means X value is 4. Remember this. You have to find the value of X. They will give you N value, P value. On the basis of N and P, calculate Q value. After calculating the Q value, you take the equation. Once you take the equation, then you have to find the value of X. In the first question, value of X is greater than 1. In the second question, what is the probability that all 4 bombs hit the bridge? All 4 means X value 4. You take X value 4 and solve the problem. Okay, you see here. So for the second question, x is equal to 4. Second question, you write the second question. All four bombs hit the bridge. I have not recorded here. Please, you write that. All four bombs hit the bridge is the question. So x is 4. All 4. N is 4. X is 4. Okay. So probability of x is equal to 4. X is equal to 4. And probability of x is equal to, your equation is ncx p raised to x q raised to n minus x. In this equation, you fill the x value and n value. So x is equal to 4. N is 4. X is 4. Probability is 0.25. Raised to x means 4. Q is 0.75 raised to n minus x. N is 4, x is 4. So 4 minus 4. 4 minus 4. 4 minus 4. You see here, probability of all four bombs hit the bridge. Clear? Then probability of x is equal to 4 is equal to 4C4 value is 1. Remember this. 4C4 value is n. And 0, 4C0 is also 1. I already told these technical terms you remember. So 4C4 is 1, 0.25 raised to 4, and 0.75 raised to 0. 4 minus 4, 0. Clear? Then probability of x is equal to 4 is equal to 0.25 raised to 4. 0.25 raised to 4. How it is? Here is 1. And 0.75. This 0.75 raised to 0. 0.75 raised to 0 means 1. If you multiply any number by 1, same number comes. So 1 is here, this 1 and this 1. will not affect, they become neutral. They become neutral and 0.25 raised to 4. So 0.25 raised to 4 is nothing but you write 0.25 four times and multiply it. So probability of x is equal to 4 is equal to 0.003906. 0.003906 is the probability. So probability of hitting all the four bombs, probability of all four bombs hit the bridge is 0.003906. This is the answer. Okay. You remember this. Come to the next question. The probability of an individual surviving after becoming a victim of cancer is 1 by 10. You see the question. Suppose if any person is suffering from the cancer disease, he survives. Probability of surviving is 1 by 10. 1 by 10 is the probability of surviving. Okay. then find the chance of survival of four individuals when six have been affected by cancer. You see this? What is the probability of surviving from the disease of cancer? Anybody tell me? What is the probability of surviving of a cancer patient? What is the probability? P value?
6.
Probability?
1/10.
Probability is 1/10. Then how many individuals are there? How many total individuals are there? How many total individuals are there affected by cancer?
Six
is the total number of members suffering from cancer. Then what is your question? Find the chance of survival of 4. So probability is 1/10 and total number of persons is 6, that is n. Then your question is find the chance of survival of 4. Survival of 4 is the x. This 4 is called as x. This 4 is called as x. Okay. That 4 is called as x. So n is equal to 6. P is equal to 1/10. Then Q is equal to 1/P is equal to 1 minus 1/10 is equal to 9/10. 9/10 is the Q. Okay. 9/10 is the Q. Then binomial equation is probability of X is equal to NCX P raised to X Q raised to N minus X. This is the equation. So X value is equal to 4. X value is X is equal to 4 means survival of 4. They asked to calculate the chance of survival of 4. Therefore, X value is 4. So probability of X is equal to 4. If you put this in the equation, probability of X is equal to NCX, P raised to X, Q raised to N minus X. In this equation, you fill the value of N and X. You fill the value of N and X. N is 6, X is 4, and P is 0.1. Is it right or wrong? P value 0.1. Am I right or wrong?
Yes.
1 divided by 10. 1 divided by 10 means 0.1. And raised to 4. X is 4. 0.9 is Q. 0.9 is Q. Is it right or wrong? Q value 0.9. 9 divided by 10. 9 divided by 10 means 0.9 or not?
0.9. Yes.
Then N minus X. N is 6, X is 4. Okay. You fill in the equation. You fill in the equation and NCX 4 C 6 C 4 0.1 raised to 4 0.9 raised to 2. Clear? 0.9 raised to 2. 6 minus 4 is equal to 2. Then you calculate the 6C4 separately. 6C4 is equal to N factorial divided by N minus R factorial into R factorial. You apply this equation and calculate. Okay, so NCX, that is 6, not 5, it is 6. 6 C. (6C4) is equal to 6 factorial divided by 6 minus 4 factorial into 4 factorial. 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 4 factorial. So,
Fifteen
is the answer. Six C four is equal to 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 4 factorial. If you simplify this, you will get 15. That is because of some technical mistakes, I'm unable to show it. Okay, you see here. 6 4 is equal to 4 factorial. 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial into 4 factorial. Then 6 × 5 × 4 factorial is equal to divided by 2 factorial into 4 factorial. 4 factorial, 4 factorial get cancels. 6 × 5 divided by 2 is equal to 15. This is the answer. Okay. So its answer is 15 into 0.1 raised to 4 into 0.9 raised to 2. If you multiply this, 15 into 0.1 raised to 4 is equal to 0.0001 into 0.81 into 0.81. If we multiply this, you will get 0.001215. This is the answer. Okay. Survival chance of four is 0.001215. You write the answer. Chance of survival of 4 individuals out of 6 affected, probability is 0.001215. This is the answer. Remember this. Okay. You see the video and solve the problems without going through the videos. You don't see the video. First, you see the video, clear your doubts, and solve the question in your book. Solve the question in your book. This is enough for today.